Welcome to a new video presented by Telescope Service, and this video is a bit different than the other ones. This is a bit more theory today because we want to explain you some well-known and common use terms in astrophotography, especially in gear setup. So for this example, I use this CF APU here and a couple of other things to explain you some of the terms that we are often stumble across and where we think they may need more explanation. So let's start with the first thing, which is pretty obvious and very easy to understand, but we are also hear often questions about it, and so I will spend some sentences on it. And it's about male and female threading. Of course, you will know what a female and a male thread is, but I will explain it again. So the male thread is the outer one, this one here, and the female thread is the inner one. So that is point one. And we are talking about this because it's important when you talk about distances here with these, for example, these spaces. The male thread here, which sticks out of the adapter, is not included in the calculation, because when you screw it into your next part of equipment, like this, this thread vanishes completely, so you don't need to take this into account. That's the important thing that I want to mention here with these threadings. Okay, the next term in our list is the so-called imaging train. I'm also pretty sure that you heard about it, but I will explain you what it is. The imaging train describes the whole setup you have in or on your focuser. That means everything that's affecting the image. Let me show you an example. With this telescope, a possible image train would consist of the reducer, and a spacer, a filter drawer, and the camera. So that's it. An imaging train can consist of multiple things, maybe a off-axis guide, a filter wheel, or some sort of prism. That is all describing the imaging train. Okay, it's time for the third term that I want to cover, and that is the camera back focus. So this is also still pretty easy. The camera back focus describes the distance from the front of the camera housing, where it connects to the next optical element, to the front of the sensor, of the CMOS or CCD sensor within the camera. When you buy a camera, you can check the specifications. This is a value that is always given in the technical specifications, because that's very important to set up your train properly. For example, this here is a big ZWO camera that has a back focus of 17.5 millimeters. But there are also many different values on the market. For example, the well-known Canon DSLR cameras use 44 millimeter, and the small ZWO cameras use, for example, 6.5 millimeters. Or maybe even smaller cameras like these planetary cameras may use even shorter back focus. Okay, so we have already set up here a possible imaging train. So I want to explain the next term with this setup. And this is the working distance. And now I need to be more specific. We are talking about the corrector working distance. All these optical correctors, reducers, flatteners have a specified distance from the back of the corrector itself, where it produces the best image, the sharpest image, so to say. And that depends on the model, on the manufacturer, and of course on the whole telescope type. So for example, this reducer here on the CF APU series uses 55 millimeter of working distance. And this is also a pretty common value among the manufacturers of these correctors, because the 55 millimeters are easily achievable and also good for additional equipment, but it is not too much. So if you plan to use big equipment, then maybe 55 can be a bottleneck. Yeah, how to achieve them? Just quickly, just here as an example, there are many ways to achieve this working distance. But for example, with a ZWO camera like this, all the needed spacers are shipped with the camera. For example, this 21 millimeter ring here. And here I use a ZWO filter drawer, and in combination with the camera, that gives, in this case, 56 millimeter of back focus. So that is okay, because here in the filter drawer, normally a filter is installed that will extend the optical path. So a millimeter more is good. And it's also possible to fine adjust this distance. Maybe the corrector is not performing well in your opinion, then you can change the distance. You can extend it by putting in spacers here, very thin spacers, half a millimeter or 1 millimeter spacers in between. So you can extend the optical path even more to check if the frame gets better, if the image gets better. Now I reassembled the setup to its original configuration. That makes explanations more easy here, that you not get distracted, because the next term is the focus position. And what does it mean? The focus position describes where your focus is when you focus at an infinite object. Let's say something 1 kilometer or more away, that's what we call infinite, will create an image somewhere like here. So the focus plane is maybe somewhere like here. And this value gets important in just a minute when we come to the next term, and this is the telescope back focus. With telescope back focus, it's just only the value meant between the innermost position and the focus position. So just as a rough estimation, with this telescope, the focal plane, the focus position is here. So the telescope back focus is this amount here, this distance. But as you see, that is not your usable value. Your usable value is this distance without all these adapters here. And this is also the last and also very important term, that is the focus of travel. So that's just the amount of distance the focuser can travel from the innermost position to, in principle, the outermost position, but more important, the focal plane. So there is also a very big difference in the position of the focal plane between infinite objects and nearer objects. So you can just try to focus on an object, let's say 20 meters away, then your focuser has to be very far out. Maybe it's not reachable, because that's an astronomical telescope, always for infinite distances. If you want to use it terrestrial, then that can be an issue. You have to extend the focuser by extension tubes. And now we come to the important thing, why I mention this value. Normally, especially with refractors like this here, reaching the focus position is not an issue, not with an eyepiece, not with a camera. That's no problem, because the focus of travel is so long. And you are always in a safe position here. You have always room to travel inwards or to travel outwards. But if you have a different configuration or a different type of telescope, like a Newtonian telescope, then the focus of travel and the focus position are really critical. Let's assume you have a Newtonian telescope with a focuser like this. This focuser gives you, let's just roughly estimate it to something around 12 millimeters, I think. So with this amount of travel, you are extremely limited to your optical configuration. You just can't use it with a camera, where the focal plane has to be here, or in exchange with an eyepiece, where the focal plane has to be here. So it is not possible. You have to configure your telescope for one usage, and this is either optical or photography. That is really important, especially with Newtonian telescopes. You can't build a longer draw tube here, because it will then stick into the tube of your telescope and then create weird image artifacts. Well, that's it. Our first 7 terms that we covered here in this little series. We are thinking about extending this series to other topics too, or even more terms. So please let me know what you are interested in to hear, maybe also with some examples or practical examples outside. So just drop a comment below or send us an email. We would really appreciate it. So until then, thank you very much for viewing and see you next time. Bye bye.